Hey corn growers, I'm Eric Wilson. Welcome back to another installment of Wiffles Hybrids Fertility 101. And today I want to talk to you a little bit about understanding nitrogen loss. So there's three main pathways for nitrogen loss. Leaching being the primary one that we talk about a lot. That's movement of nitrate through the soil with water. Second being denitrification. That's conversion of nitrate to dinitrogen. Typically happens under those saturated and warm or flooded conditions. And the last one being volatilization. That would be the gaseous loss of ammonia from urea or ammonia-based fertilizers. Back to the first one, leaching. Loss of nitrate through the soil-water profile. So nitrate is the most abundant form of nitrogen because typically under warm spring conditions, all forms of nitrogen convert to nitrate. It does have a negative charge, so it's not held by the soil cation exchange, and it readily moves with water. Losses are directly dependent on rainfall and temperature. However, it's not always associated with heavy rainfall events. And in fact, a lot of heavy rainfall events, you can get surface runoff that doesn't move down through that soil profile. Something to keep in mind, if you've had early season heavy rainfall events, some of that nitrogen that you applied in particular as anhydrous is likely not converted to nitrate yet. Again, temperature here being the key, you have to have those warm temperatures for ammonia to convert to nitrate in order for it to be leached through that profile. Second, denitrification. This would be the primary loss pathway under those flooded conditions. Again, this is very dependent on temperature, and losses per day can range from 2 to 5%, with our range in temperature being 50 to 60 degrees for that 2%, 65 plus degrees for 5% or greater losses per day. Significant loss does happen under saturated soil conditions, especially when we have those warmer temperatures later in the spring. Lastly, volatilization. This is typically not a primary loss pathway for a lot of us, but it can happen. It's directly associated with surface applied fertilizers that are left unincorporated. So if we do a top dressing of urea, we're spinning it on with the spinner cart, it doesn't get incorporated around side dress time. Keep in mind, we have to have a little bit of rainfall to get that nitrogen to move down into the soil profile, or unless we're doing some tillage early spring to incorporate that. Again, this isn't probably a primary loss pathway, but it can occur, and I want you guys to be aware of it. So lastly, some management tips on knowing when to act if you suspect that you've had some nitrogen loss. Above average spring rainfall, specifically between May and June, usually justifies additional nitrogen applications above what you've already done. If ponding or saturated soils have existed for extended periods, assume that you've probably lost some nitrogen. Keep in mind, these are all back to temperature dependent. If it's happening early season, and we don't have the warm temperatures to get conversion to happen, unlikely that we've lost a lot of nitrogen, especially if it's still in the ammonium form. Lastly, maybe you guys are using a spring soil nitrate test. It's coming back low. That absolutely justifies doing something for an additional nitrogen application. With that, I hope you guys took something from this video. I appreciate your time. Thank you very much.